What's up, guys? It's Andrew from Motorcycles Off-Road.
And right here, this is my Tenere 700. Why did I put this in this video? Well, we'll double back to this in just a minute. But this particular video, we're talking about the WR250R, the possible WR300R, or 350R. So as you guys know, the WR250R was canceled after 2020. The 2021 model press conference from Yamaha, they had this to say: with deep consideration of evolving global market trends and regulations that limits production volumes on certain models, the following Yamaha models will be discontinued after this model year, 2020. YZF R6, VMAX, WR250R, and S-MAX. Yamaha understands the deep iconic history of these models. Regarding the future, Yamaha is continuously looking at new ideas and concepts to support and expand the market, as well as enhance our customers' experiences. But that's not news to anybody. We know this bike's canceled, but why were they canceled? Seems like there's a huge cult following behind this bike. A lot of people swear by this bike. It's like a love-hate relationship. I've seen people that love the bike so much, and then I've seen people that said the bike was mediocre at best. But let's think about why they're canceled. They'd be canceled because how many people were really buying a WR250R new? It may not be as many as you think. And to be quite honest, I don't see too many of these bikes around, although I see a ton of KTMs, Hondas, Kawasaki's, and also the WR has a huge used market as well. And that's a great thing for us because that means you can get it at a fraction of the price, but that's a bad thing for Yamaha in a way if you never change the mod. See, just hear me out for a second. Let's think about most people that do dual sport riding, right? They get really into it, they love it, but the life of a lot of people, now I'm not saying people like me or you, but I'm saying a lot of people that get into the hobby, they may be into the hobby for like 5 years or so, and then they put it down for a while, then maybe they pick it up later in life. And the reason being is because life changes. Maybe they had a child, different things, different circumstances, you know, their new job, they have a commute, whatever it may be. It's hard for somebody to have a passionate hobby in any one thing, especially something that is demanding as dual sporting, for an extended period of time. A lot of us manage to do it just for our sheer love of dual sporting, but there's also a lot of people that can't because of life, and that makes a lot of sense. So what happens? Well, they either sell the bike straight away, or the bike sits for a couple years and then they say, hey guys, it's just collecting dust, does anybody want this? And then they sell it a couple years later. So you as the consumer goes and sees, oh, this is a WR250R, I've heard that's a great bike, I rode my buddies, whatever, this one only has 3,000 to 5,000 miles on it, a single cylinder engine, that's like brand new. So you buy the bike, and that's one less sale coming off the showroom floor for Yamaha. Couple that with the fact that Kawasaki released their 300, Honda released their 300, and at least on the side of the Honda, it's a completely redesigned model and has a lot of attention. That's also going to hurt your sales as being Yamaha with the WR250. Then also you have tighter and tighter emissions and regulations coming from other countries, like demanding ABS, also a thing that can hurt your bike from being sold. So logically it makes sense. And if I could say one thing about Yamaha, they are willing to experiment and I love it. Sometimes good, sometimes bad. So what's next? What are we going to have next? Well, maybe we're going to have a WR350 or WR300, right? Now, don't get me wrong. I love my Honda 300L. I've had a ton of dual sports over the years, but I absolutely will have the next Yamaha dual sport just because I have faith in that company and what they can do. So let's talk a second about the dream Yamaha WR. So for me personally, as I showed, I have a Tenere. Love the bike. There was a lot of R&D in this bike. In fact, 3 or 4 years in R&D in this bike, at least that we know of, after it was announced, that is. My unicorn of a bike would be high countershaft like the Tenere, bouncing like the Tenere, fuel injection, 6-speed transmission, wide ratio, and make it a WR350. You will blow the market out of the water. You could charge $8,000, $8,500 for this bike, call it the Mini Tenere. At least I'm coining that phrase right now. That's what we would call it. We would call it the Mini Tenere, and it'd be half the size of the Tenere. Keep the weight the best you can under 300 pounds stock, because we all know when we take off that exhaust, change a couple things around, we'll be able to get the bike down to 280, 270 pounds, which is amazing for a dual sport. And if it's balanced correctly, then this would be a dream bike. Now, the one disclaimer is we shouldn't hold our breath, because once again, the Tenere is, in my opinion, a work of art. But developing this Tenere from an engine they have already had took years. Took years getting the frame perfect, so we have a perfect balance between 52 and 48% balance front and rear wheel, and that super high countershaft that gives us that amazing traction whenever we blip the throttle. Like, this bike plants the front wheel down for you the more gas you give. That is counterintuitive to most of the riding that you've ever done, and it makes it very nimble despite its size on making turns on the trail. Now, I'm not saying you want to take the Tenere 700 on single track. I mean, some people do, but I'm not going to. What I'm saying is this bike is probably revolutionary in what it is and what it can do for being a 450-pound motorcycle. Now, if you had another one of these running around 170 pounds less, it would be amazing. It would probably be that unicorn. It's weird, everybody in the dual sport community says the word unicorn, and I started watching other people's videos, and now I find myself saying it. So full disclosure, I didn't actually like my WR250R, and this is where everybody's gonna lose their mind. Everybody's like, how do you not like that bike? I preferred my DR350S on the road, and when it came to off-road, I had better off-road models. I had a lot more fun on, let's say, like a DRZ or my KX250. Actually, let me backtrack a second. Let me say first, the WR250R has a very high seat height, which is fine. It's got good suspension. That's great. But for me, that's a little bit uncomfortable. I like the 35-inch seat height. So if I'm going to sacrifice the seat height to the 37-inch mark, I want something with a lot more power, right? So I'm going to deal with the DRZ, for example. So hence why if you made a 300 or a 350 WR and you gave it that power, just a slight edge over the 300L and a KLX 300, then I'd be willing to take that ride. But that's just my opinion. Some people regard it as one of the best dual sports ever made. But then once again, I don't see a lot of them around. It's not like this is the go-to thing. In fact, the DRZ is one of the most common dual sports I ever see because it's such a utilitarian bike that can do so much. The other funny part is me making all these 300L videos because I love that bike. People accused me of being a Honda or 300L fanboy. And to them I say, look at my Raptor 660, my Warrior 350, my son's PW80, my daughter's TTR 125, my girlfriend's TW 200, and my Tenere 700, all purchased by me. I'm not a fanboy of any of these companies. I just love power sports. But it seems to be the ones that I hold on to the most end up being the Yamahas for some reason. Never going to get rid of this 300L though. That's a great bike. So the WR350R, let's say, the Mini Tenere, I will reserve it the day it comes out. I have already told my salesman. I said when the new WR is announced, you reserve it for me. I'll be in here a day or two later to put the down deposit. And I know he knows I mean business because I bought two brand new bikes off of him this year alone. And back to the Tenere 700. Yes, I have a Tenere 700. I put a little poll up for you guys and asked what you guys wanted to see, like if I should just stick with the 300L or if I should trickle into Tenere. And a lot of you guys said you wanted to see the Tenere as well, which is great news because this channel is supposed to be motorcycles off-road, not 300L only. And I have a big camping trip coming up next month, which is going to be traveling mostly off-road for 4 days and camping in 3 different state parks, and I'm going to be doing all that off the Tenere 700. So I'm glad to hear that you guys will actually enjoy that content. That's just not going to be wasted, or if I should maybe make the trip on my 300L, because that's probably not happening. I got the Tenere for that purpose, adventure bike to do adventure things, and I'm really looking forward to that. So guys, what do you think? Would you get a WR300R or a 350R? How long do you think it's going to take Yamaha to make this thing? And I'll tell you what, it's probably worth the wait. And then lastly, as a guy getting into moto camping, since I've done tons of camping, I haven't done too much moto camping, is there any points of advice you guys could give me? I mean, it seems pretty cut and dry to me. It seems like my regular camping, except I'm going to be taking a little less stuff, minimalist, and trying to keep the packs within my weight limits. And then that's about it. But if there's any advice you guys can give me, put it in the comments below. You'll be able to go through this journey with me together, and I should have a 4 or 5 part series on my camping trip. So for the few of you that have watched this long, you guys are awesome. You guys are my true fans, and I love you guys. You guys are what keep me going with this channel. Thanks for watching. My name is Andrew, and this is Motorcycles Off-Road. Stay safe out there, guys.